Hello everyone, now we are going to start and we are going to continue from the previous session in which we discussed the consequences of boundary layer formation. Ultimately, with the help of continuity equation, we have understood that there is loss in the mass flow rate of the fluid because of formation of boundary layer. Because of boundary layer formation, the flow needs to accelerate due to reduction in the available flow area or cross-sectional area. In reference to this, we will understand some important definitions. First one is boundary layer thickness itself. It is the distance measured from the boundary of the solid surface in the direction perpendicular to the direction of the flow, that is y direction, up to the point where velocity of the fluid is approximately equal to 0.99 times the free stream velocity. It is denoted by symbol delta. Second important definition is displacement thickness delta star. It is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid surface by which the boundary should be displaced so that we can compensate for reduction in the flow rate which has occurred due to boundary layer formation. Displacement thickness is indicated by the symbol delta star. Now we will understand the concept of displacement thickness in somewhat more detail. Let us consider the simple boundary layer formation as well as the formation of velocity gradient as can be seen over here. Delta indicates the boundary layer thickness, which means up to this point the velocity of the fluid particle will be as good as 0.99 times the mainstream velocity capital U. Beyond this thickness, the velocity will be exactly equal to the free stream velocity capital U. Now, what will happen if there was no viscosity? If there is a fluid which is having zero viscosity, that is mu is equal to zero, then there will not be any formation of boundary layer. We observe over here that due to formation of velocity gradient, this gap is left. This gap indicates somewhat loss in this velocity which happened because of boundary layer formation. If there was no viscosity of the fluid, there was no boundary layer, then length of all these arrows would have been equal. In that case, velocity at any point small u would be equal to free stream velocity capital U. But because of presence of viscosity, means viscosity of the fluid is not equal to zero, that's why boundary layer formation will happen, velocity gradient will be created, and velocity at any point will be the function of, it will be dependent on distance of that point from the boundary surface, which means small u is function of small u, or is the function is dependent on distance y. Now this gap over here, it actually represents the loss of velocity, which can be mathematically calculated as free stream velocity minus local velocity small u. Now how to calculate this total area, which is loss of velocity and ultimately the loss of flow rate? Remember, when we say the loss of velocity, we are also talking about loss of flow rate, because simply when we multiply the velocity with area, we get the flow rate. So if there is loss of velocity for the same area, which means we are also talking about loss of flow rate. So if we want to quantify this loss in velocity and ultimately loss in flow rate, we have to consider some thickness in the rectangular plane. This thickness is indicated by delta star, which is called as displacement thickness. And the second parameter to calculate the area will be width of the plate. So as we understood, capital U minus small u indicates the velocity deficit and ultimately the loss of flow rate. Now we will mathematically quantify these parameters so that we can obtain some concrete formula for their quantification. For this, let us consider a simple flat plate on which flow is approaching with a velocity u. Now, also there is formation of boundary layer on this plate. We can see the parabolic velocity distribution because of velocity gradient. We are going to consider this small elemental strip which is having thickness dy. This elemental strip is located at a distance y away from the boundary surface or plate surface. This section BC indicates the thickness of boundary layer delta. So we will start our derivation. Distance BC is equal to boundary layer thickness delta. y is the distance of elemental strip from the plate, dy is thickness of elemental strip, u is the velocity of the fluid at elemental strip. Remember, this is the local velocity, small u. B is width of plate. Now, we need to understand the width of plate for this context, because that will help us to calculate area available for the flow. In three dimension, plate will look something like this, and this will be the width of the plate, which is right now perpendicular to the plane of the paper in z direction. And the thickness of the elemental strip is dy, which is indicated over here as well. Now, because of combination of these two parameters, flow area can be calculated as, because it is very small area, that's why dA, and it will be equal to b into dy. So this is the area that we are talking about, b into dy. This is the area through which flow of the fluid will take place. Now, we can calculate the mass of the fluid flowing per second through the elemental strip simply using continuity equation. So it will be equal to rho AV, density into area of strip into velocity of the fluid through that particular strip only. So this will be rho into area of strip dA and velocity of the fluid through the strip u. So this will be rho b dy into u. Let us mark this as equation number 1. Now, if there was no plate and if there was no formation of boundary layer, then fluid would have flown at a velocity equal to the free stream velocity directly. Then mass flow rate of the fluid through the strip per second, if there was no plate, and from the same area the fluid could have gone by the rate of density into area into free stream velocity, which is equal to density into area of the strip multiplied by the free stream velocity. Consider this as equation number 2. Now, in this case, free stream velocity is larger than the local velocity of the fluid particle or fluid layer. It means that due to the presence of the plate and consequent formation of boundary layer, the mass flow rate of the fluid per second through the strip actually reduces. We need to quantify this in the mathematical form. So this reduction in mass flow rate is nothing but the mass flow rate with free stream velocity minus mass flow rate with the local velocity. That is equation 2 minus equation 1. So what we get is that rho v dy are common parameters in both the terms, and only subtraction of capital U and small u will happen. So this is reduction in mass flow rate. Now remember, this reduction in mass flow rate is for the elemental strip, and that's why this dy is over here. But we want the total reduction in mass flow rate, which can be obtained by integrating this differential quantity within the limits of integration. We will also understand the logic about defining the limits of integration. So total reduction in the mass flow rate of the fluid due to the presence of the plate and presence of boundary layer, it is equal to integral of the previous quantity rho b dy into capital U minus small u within the limits of integration 0 to delta. Now, how to define these limits of integration? 0 indicates the surface of the plate itself, and delta indicates the boundary layer thickness. Why? Because this is the lowest surface that the fluid can contact, and this is the highest length or highest distance at which the effect of boundary layer is being felt. It is significant. Beyond this delta thickness, remember, the velocity is equal to free stream velocity. There are no viscous effects, and that's why the final limit of integration will be delta. So now we have defined the limits of integration. Now we have the differential quantity to indicate the mass flow rate, and that's why we can now perform the integration. In this case, density of the fluid and width of the plate will be constant. That's why they can come out of the integral sign. So the final quantity becomes rho b into integral of u minus u into dy within the limits 0 to delta. Now, we want to understand the quantification of delta star. So let us assume that the plate is displaced by the displacement thickness equal to delta star. Through this delta star, the velocity of the flow would be equal to free stream velocity. Remember the case when there was no viscosity and when there was viscosity. So we are trying to equate the loss of mass flow rate for the same area. Now, considering delta star, The loss of mass of fluid per second flowing through the distance delta star will be given again by continuity equation, which is rho AB. So rho into area delta star into B multiplied by free stream velocity capital U. Now both these two quantities represent loss of mass flow rate, and that's why they are equal to each other. So now we will equate them. What we get is, on the left hand side we have our integral quantity because of presence of the plate, and on the right hand side we have loss in the flow rate because of the which is going through the displacement thickness. Now cancelling the quantity rho b from both the sides, we get this equation, and ultimately after adjustment what we get is expression for displacement thickness delta star. So delta star is given as integral from 0 to delta of the quantity 1 minus small u upon capital U with respect to y. So this is the expression for displacement thickness. In the similar fashion, we can also obtain expression for other quantities of importance such as momentum thickness and energy thickness. And the definition also is on the same grounds as that of displacement thickness. So let us move forward. Let us now understand the momentum thickness. Similar to the displacement